Hello, my name is Beth Brewster, and this is my video to talk about the 10 best tips for those who are looking to enter the hospitality business. I chose this because it's kind of the information I would want to know if I'm going into hospitality, and it's helpful for those that think they might have a passion for it, but just want to know what all it entails before they spend time and money on it that's not necessary. All right. So right now I currently work at David's Bridal as a customer service representative. I've also worked at Things Remembered, and I've worked as a sales associate at my parents' business, answering phones and dealing with customers and that sort of thing. So I have quite a bit of customer service experience. So for the first tip, it's make time for yourself. In customer service, there's going to be a point where you're just drained. You've dealt with difficult customers, you've worked long hours, and your feet are tired. You just want to be able to take that time for yourself and relax. And personally, what I do to take time for myself is I'll go to the gym, and it just kind of refreshes me and makes sure I'm still motivated. Or another big thing is I just sit down and have a nice breakfast. Breakfast is my favorite meal of the day, and I know a lot of college kids skip breakfast, but really that's just the time for me to relax, eat my meal, and kind of start the day off right. For number two, the advice I'm going to give you is that there's always going to be difficult customers, no matter how nice you are. For me, I'm one of the smiliest, happiest people, and it shocked me how rude people can be that are visiting hospitality businesses. And usually the people that do happen to be nice also work in hospitality, so they kind of see it from your point of view. But you just gotta realize that the people that are angry, they might be angry at company policy, or maybe they're just having a bad day. It may not have anything to do with you, so you kind of gotta let it roll off of you. For number three, I'm gonna tell you about the average work day. Kind of what to expect is that you're still gonna have to work. I think a lot of people, they think of hospitality and they think, oh, I can just smile and talk to people and just kind of relax. But you have to be aware that you're gonna have to find a balance between trying to complete your tasks and still connecting with the customer. Number four, some of the few characteristics that you definitely need if you want to work in hospitality. Number one is going to be communication. It is imperative that you use that, because if you can't communicate with your coworkers or guests, then people are going to be angry with you, and you really can't do anything in the business if you don't know how to communicate. Another thing is leadership. You want to be one of those people that work at everything 110% and try to help others if you can. Because if you're somebody who just works enough to not get fired, it makes everything difficult. And if everybody has the attitude of working 110%, it makes the whole day go a lot smoother. Also, organization is important. If you have several tasks to do and you have to walk off for a couple of minutes to go complete one, you need to be able to come back and say, okay, what was I working on? And have that place right there, because if not, it could get you in a bunch of trouble. And the last one I'm going to say is enthusiasm. You'll see in companies like Chick-fil-A and Disney how they're so successful, and I think a lot of it comes from the people they hire. They hire people who are smiley and happy and just ready to work for others and serve others, and I think that adds to the experience. All right, number five, you definitely earn your money. Don't expect to go to work and just be standing around bored, having nothing to do, or goofing off. hospitality is definitely a job where you are constantly having something to do. Even if you don't have tasks, you can go around and ask how customers are doing. There's always something that's a little extra that you can do if you can't find anything. Number six, you will be standing all day. In most hospitality jobs, you're going to be standing or walking, and at first your feet are going to hurt, but eventually you'll get used to it. And then number seven, don't forget your southern manners. It seems obvious, but hold doors for people, be polite, use your manners, and say thank you at least 100 times a day, because people love hearing that. Number eight, make connections. I know you don't want to be burning bridges with anybody. You want to try and make connections through your jobs, internships, friends, because that's how you get the jobs. It's always about who you know. And if you end up burning bridges, you never know who's going to end up being your boss for a dream job you want later in life. So just be wary of that. And then number nine, make plans. This is super important, especially in college, because really you can get anywhere as long as you have a goal in mind and you map out a plan for that. If you are just planning on passing all your classes and graduating college with a degree and you think you're home free, that's not going to be the case. It's really important that you do internships. Make those connections, like I was saying. And if you have a goal in mind, it's easier to map out the steps you need to take to be able to get to that goal. And then number 10, at the end of the day, it's worth it. Whenever you're done with your day and you're tired and your feet hurt and everything like that, you just pause and take a moment and you feel like you've accomplished something. You feel like you've made a difference. And you feel like you're constantly learning new things, and it's a good feeling to have. All right, so I hope you guys take these tips and use this if you think you might want a degree in hospitality. And after seeing this, if you think, yeah, hospitality is definitely for me, there is tons of opportunities. Really, you can get as far as you want. It really depends on how hard you're planning to work. But just make sure to do that hard work earlier rather than later, and then you can reap the benefits in the end. All right. Thank you, guys.